Hello, this is John Schaap and welcome to this video in the updated 2021 version of AOS 8 video series. In this video, we are going to have a look at how to configure and troubleshoot the mobility conductor and mobility controllers. It's very important to fully understand how hierarchical configuration is done from the mobility conductor only and not on the individual mobility controllers. We will both use the web user interface and the command line interface for this. The network still looks the same as in the other videos, so a mobility conductor and backup conductor and a controller cluster of three virtual mobility controllers, three access points and a ClearPass server and Windows 2022 server for DHCP and DNS. Our whole network, as can be seen from the mobility conductor, so we have a web session to the mobility conductor only, and you see the mobility conductor here on the left-hand side. Number one is the active one, number two is the standby one, and below that we have the managed network with the folders that I've created in previous videos and the three virtual mobility controllers over here, VMC 1, 2 and 3, configured in a controller cluster. One thing that I didn't show you yet is you have the overview of the controllers here, but you can also see them on a map to easily see how your network is doing and if there are any issues. So you just click here on this symbol, and that brings you to an overview of the three controllers. You see here a circle in green with the number three. That means that there are three controllers in good health. It will turn yellow or red in case there is something wrong with the controllers. If you do list, you see the list of the three controllers that you also see on the left-hand side. So let's have a look at how configuration is done here. So as I said in previous videos, it starts here at the root at managed network. You will find a lot of default config items there. So here are all the default config items. You see a lot of roles, there's a lot of policies and other stuff in here. And it's recommended not to add, change or do anything in this level. You start one group below, and that is in this case here at HPE. So you give that folder a name. It's normally the company name or whatever you want. And then you can either put your devices in here or go down further with another folder like I did here with APJ, EMEA and US, and then place the physical devices. So you see this is a folder that's open, this is closed, and this is a device icon before these three. So these are three devices, can either be physical or virtual. It has the same symbol, and the other ones are just folders. And everywhere there is configuration. So like I already discussed before, if you configure something at this level, it flows down to all the other ones. If you configure something here, it flows down only to the three members of that group. And if you configure something on an individual device, it's only seen on that individual device. So let's go to VMC 01 and go to AP groups. You can see here that I have created two AP groups, EMEA AP group and global AP group. The global AP group is configured here at HPE level and EMEA is configured at EMEA level. If I select them, you see that there's a blue exclamation mark. If you click that, it tells you where the group was created. So this one was created in EMEA. If I select the other one, global one was configured in HPE and the other one was in EMEA. So there's a difference in where they are configured. So this symbol, just click it to see where something is created if you need to know how the hierarchy is working. So let's go to here, close this one and go to profiles and we go to wireless LAN. To the radio server CPPM. So this radio server is configured again at a higher level and it is then configured here at the lower level. So now you can always override items at a lower level. So let's do a override here. So let's say I want to enable this only on this controller and not on that one, not on that one, and not anywhere else. I click submit. And then when we go back to that same radius server, you'll see another thing. Now there is a blue dot in front of the item. That means if you click it, it tells you what it is. It says that the value has been overwritten for this specific device. It tells you if it is set anywhere else, so it's not set on EMEA and not set on HPE. So you can remove the override here, or you can just cancel and leave it as it is. So if this was overwritten and it was configured already at the higher level, it will show you here also what was the value at the higher level. So this is what we mean with overriding config that was done at a higher level and overriding it at a lower level. And the blue dot indicates that it has happened. So this one, for instance, mode, that is already configured at every other level. So that does not have the blue dot because it's not an override. So let's go to HPE and to roles, and let's create a role. Call it test role. Okay, so select the test role and we go advanced view and modify this one, and we add a rule for the test role. And we just do any. And we create here a host 10.10.200.100. And we're gonna deny that. Submit and deploy it. And because we created the test role at this level, it's now found everywhere below. So now we're gonna go to the EMEA, and you find the test role there, of course. You see the rule that we created here. So let's say you want to modify this now by doing another one. And this is for ICMP, and I want to deny that. Submit. Then you see here in the bottom, it says it is an inherited session ACL test role, cannot be edited at this node. So these are the five items that I discussed in previous videos that cannot be overwritten at the lower levels. So almost everything can be overwritten except five things that cannot be overwritten. If you try to modify them, you see this message here down below. So this cannot be overwritten. You have to do this in a different way. So we're going to cancel that. And now we're going to create a VLAN. So we already had the guest VLAN and the employee VLAN. Now we're going to create a test VLAN. And we're going to give that ID 213. Okay. That's configured here at EMEA level. So that means that you see it here, and as I showed before, at the three controllers, but not over there. It's not there. So it also means that you now can go to your to the previous configured wireless LAN that we have here. So we have employee, and we can go to the VLAN, and we can now change it. So it's set to employee VLAN at this level, and we can now override that at a lower level with the test VLAN. And this is something that can be overwritten. So you see that has happened right now. We overwritten the value that was configured here previously at a lower level. Show you that one more time. So you see that it is test VLAN. The VLAN is down here. Okay, so that's basically how the configuration hierarchy works. So it's very important that you do everything at the right level. If you don't do that, it's going to become a mess and your configuration becomes unusable. So be very precise and accurate in configuring and looking at what you have selected here on the left-hand side before you start configuring things. One other thing that I want to show you is in admin preferences, there's the show advanced profiles. That is normally unchecked, so you don't see the advanced profiles in the config, to keep it a little bit simpler. If you want to see all the profiles and everything, just enable it and save it. It's not that you see an immediate change right now, but in some config items, more things are there. So if you then go to AP groups and select an AP group, you will see that you have the tabs here. But now that we have selected the advanced profiles, there's also this item here on the right-hand side. That is not there if you do not select that in admin preferences. And that's where you can go directly to the profiles. So the profiles, I'm going to show you that in the CLI, are very important. You also find the profiles here in system profiles. And these are all the profiles that are configurable on the system. And there are a lot of profiles. And that's also hierarchical config. So let's go to the command line interface. And go to the mobility conductor. Show switches is a very important command to see how your configuration is synchronizing. The configuration state should always be in update successful. If there's anything else there, something went wrong and your configuration is not synchronizing. It also means that the config ID needs to be the same on every device. So all configuration is done on the conductor. And when you do write mem or save it in the web user interface, it is then sent to the standby conductor and to the three different managed devices. You do not configure anything at the level of the managed device, except the initial config that you did when you installed the system. That's the only time that you configure something there. And after that, you do not configure anything anymore over there. The only exception is if you want to change something on the standby mobility conductor. That's where you can go either with the CLI or with the web user interface, just by going to the individual IP address and change things there. Because I showed you already before, you cannot do that from the web user interface. So you can change things here on mobility conductor 1. That's the active one. But if you select the standby, you see this. Because also here there is a hierarchy. It's relatively simple here. There's the mobility conductor. Whenever you configure something here, it goes there and there. But if you configure something here, it only goes to this active mobility conductor and not to the standby. So if you want to change something on the standby, just open a, so like for instance, the host name, that's something that you would change there. You cannot do that from here. You have to go to the individual mobility conductor with the web user interface or with the command line interface and change it there. So the other thing that you can do here is show switches debug. Gives you almost the same information, but now you also see the node path. So you see where the device is. So the mobility conductor is always in MM. MM stands for Mobility Master, that's something from the past that's now changed to Mobility Conductor. It's just a name change. So this means Mobility Conductor My Node, that's the Mobility Conductor itself. And the other one is in MM. So there's no My Node underneath because it's the standby Mobility Conductor. And then you see all the other devices are not under MM, but they are under MD, Managed Device. That's the same again as managed network here. So this is MM and this is slash MD. And then you see that the devices, the mobility controllers, are under slash MD, under slash HPE slash EMEA. That's where I put them. So if you want to see the directory where you are in right now, because right now this is a connection to the mobility conductor. So I'm not connected. I am connected to the mobility controllers also individually, here, here, and here. But those are individual SSH sessions. So here I can now do print working directory, and it says where I am. I am in MM my node. If I want to change to another node, I do. If I want to go to MM, for instance, I do cd MM, and then the prompt change to MM, and pwd change to MM. If you want to see how the whole directory structure is looking, you do cd change directory question mark. So you see root slash md, mdhpe, mdhpa-apj, and the three bonds that I created, and then the mobility conductor and the mobility conductor itself. And for the mobility controllers that you add, it automatically creates aliases. So I have three aliases here, VMC 1, 2, and 3, and they are aliases for this whole path. So if I want to change to a mobility controller, I do cd VMC 01, and you see that it changed to the MAC address of the controller. If you now do pwd, it shows you the whole path. So we're now in slash md, hpe, emea, and the MAC address of the controller. Now, you're not actually connected to the controller right now. So if you do things like show VLAN, or show running config, or whatever show command, that is the show command on the mobility conductor, always from here. And it also tells you that you cannot do show VLAN from this level. You have to go to the slash mm3. So let's do the show running config then. So some people now think that because they are in the mobility controller, that issuing a show running config shows the running config of the mobility controller. And that is not true. The show running config shows you the running config of the mobility conductor, always. And all the other show commands will do the same. So if you do show VLAN at the right level, it will show you the VLANs on the mobility conductor, not on the mobility controller. So there's two ways of doing that, or multiple ways of doing it. You either type MDC. That opens up the managed device shell to the mobility controller. So now we are in virtual mobility controller 1 via an MDC session. So if you now do show VLAN, it shows you the VLANs on the mobility controller. And you see here that 213, that was the one that we previously configured over in the web user interface. So if I now do show running config, it shows me the running config of the mobility controller and not the conductor. So to go out of here, you type exit, and we're back where we were before. So if you are at this level, so we are still at one of the mobility controllers, if you now want to see what configuration is effective from the mobility conductor without going, so either you go there with an MDC session and do show running config, or you go there with an individual session like here and you do your show running config like this, of course, that's the same. So if I do show VLAN here, it shows you the same VLANs as we just saw on the other screen. But there's a lot of configuration commands on the mobility conductor. If you do show configuration question mark, so you see that all these commands are there, and I'm going to highlight some of them that are very useful. So show configuration effective. That is the configuration that is sent from the mobility conductor to the mobility controller. So this is the effective config that runs on the mobility controller. If you do show configuration effective detail, it tells you where the config comes from. So there's a lot of default stuff that you can see here, inherited from slash. But there's also some local stuff that was configured purely on that controller. This was configured, for instance, this is the IPsec key that was configured during initial setup when we configured the mobility controller for the first time. So here you can see where all these commands come from. Most of them are inherited from root, but some of them are from MDHPE, as you can see here. That's my wireless LAN that I configured. And the same here, an access list. So this is very useful to see how the configuration is doing. And the other one is show configuration committed. That is the whole configuration that's committed to this mobility controller without all the default stuff. So this is the config that we as an administrator created and that is sent to the mobility controller. So let's go back to a individual mobility controller and then see what happens if we try to configure items from here. So we do configure terminal, and then you get this message. Like I said before, all the configuration is done from the mobility conductor only. You cannot do anything at a lower level anymore. So it says this controller is managed by mobility conductor. Configuration changes can only be performed on the mobility conductor. There's one way to overcome this, and that's called disaster recovery mode. If I go first back to the mobility conductor and do show switches again to see if everything is in synchronization, you see everything is fine here at the configuration state. So we go now here and we go in disaster recovery on mode. And now we are in disaster recovery mode. Now we can do config terminal and we can change whatever we need to change on this thing. But this is only if you are in a situation where the mobility controller is not able to communicate with the mobility conductor anymore. So if you change something on a VLAN IP route or you did something wrong, this is a way to recover from that. But be careful, if you change something here right now, because you have to turn off, you have to turn it off again. Because if you look now at the mobility conductor, you see that VMC01 is in disaster recovery mode. So that means in this mode, an administrator is locally changing things on that node. And whenever he goes out of disaster recovery mode, the mobility conductor will synchronize everything again from the mobility conductor. So if you made the mistake on the mobility conductor, and that's typical that you do that on the mobility conductor because that's the way you do configuration, you have to modify it also at the mobility conductor, because otherwise you change it locally at the node and you go back. So you go out of it again, and you do a write mem, and then you do a disaster recovery off, and then it goes back to normal, and then you'll see what happens at the mobility conductor. The mobility conductor will say, okay, it went from config disaster recovery mode to update required, and it will now update the config again. So if the error is still in the configuration of the mobility conductor, it will override it again and you're back to where you were before. So let's break the communication between a mobility controller and the mobility conductor. We go to interfaces on VMC01 and we're going to remove the VLAN that we use to communicate between the controller and the conductor. We're going to remove that from the allowed VLAN list, and that will effectively break the communication between the controller and the mobility conductor. So we're going to save it, and then we're going to have a look at the command line interface. And we see that the VMC01 is now in update required. So it's not successfully synchronizing the configuration anymore. And then after 5 or 10 minutes, the controller finds out that there is no communication between the controller and the conductor anymore. And it goes into config rollback state. That means that it will use the last known working config so that it can communicate with the conductor. You still need to modify the configuration then to make it work again. But config rollback is there so that you do not lose communication with your controllers if you make a mistake. So you're gonna modify the interface again, and then everything should become normal again. So you see that it is now propagating the config. And that now all devices are in successful again. And the alert will then go away and everything is up and running again. So config rollback is a very handy feature if you make mistakes, so that you never lose the communication between the mobility conductor and the controller. This brings us to the end of this video, so let's recap what we have done up to now. We looked at how to configure mobility controllers from a mobility conductor, and that the mobility conductor is the source of all configuration and that everything is synchronized to all mobility controllers. Configuration is hierarchical, and most items except IP access list, user role, AAA server group and AAA user derivation can be overwritten at a lower level. Please like, subscribe and let me know in the comments what you think. Bye for now.